Hello and welcome to Umbraco Learning Base, Jonathan here. In this video, we're going to have a look at Umbraco Deploy and the features it has to offer. Umbraco Deploy is first and foremost the engine that runs on Umbraco Cloud, which takes care of all deployment processes of both code, schema, and content on projects. Umbraco Deploy is also available with a license for on-premise Umbraco websites. When on-premise, a CI/CD build server needs to be set up between environments, which will then extract the changes you push into your production website that has been connected with Umbraco Deploy. For a detailed guide on how to set up a CI/CD build server, I've added a link to the documentation on how to do so in the description down below. Once you have installed Umbraco Deploy, you will see a new workspace dashboard in the content section and a deployed dashboard in the settings section of your Umbraco project. Great! Let's first have a look at the workspace dashboard in the content section of the Umbraco project. Great! As you can see, I'm in my Umbraco back office here. And the first thing that we'll notice is that the workspace dashboard up here. Here we can see the different environments that have been set up for our Umbraco project. In my case, I have a local workspace, which I'm currently on. I have a development workspace, and I have a live workspace as well. Down below, we can see the transfer queue. Currently, it's empty as we haven't set anything up to being transferred. To transfer content nodes, we can go up to our content over here. As you can see, I have a bit of content in here. And if I want to just transfer my welcome node here, I can right-click on the three dots here, and I can go down to queue for transfer. So let's click queue for transfer. We can decide if we want to include all the items below the welcome node. Let's just do that. And we can set a date for when the nodes should be published. So we can choose a date here. Let's just choose not to set a date. If we click queue here, we can see that the changes have now been queued. We can either open the transfer queue or we can just close it down. Let's just go ahead and open the transfer queue here. And let's refresh the queue. And as you can see, we have now one change queued for transfer to our development workspace. So if we open it up here, we can see that it's our welcome node, including all items below. So now we can either go ahead and transfer to the development environment, we can refresh the queue, or we can also clear the queue. Awesome. The same applies for media as well. So if you want to transfer up media that isn't been used on a content node, we can go ahead and queue it for transfer as well. So if you just take this folder here and take all the items below and queue it and open the transfer queue, we can now see that the media items are also queued for transfer as well. Awesome. Okay, so now that we've had a look at how you can transfer up your content nodes from one environment to the next, let's now have a look at the Deploy Settings dashboard. The Deploy Settings dashboard can be found in the Settings section. In the Settings section, we have these dashboards up in the top here, and if you go down here, we can see that we have the Deploy dashboard. In here, we have a few options that we can have a look at. First off, we have the deploy status. The deploy status shows you the version of deploy you're running, in this case 11.0.1. We can see the status of the last deployment. In this case, the last deployment operation was completed. We can also see when the last operation happened as well. And we can, of course, also refresh the status to see when the last one happened. Next up, we have the deploy operations. Here, we can update the Umbraco schema from data files, which will update the Umbraco schema based on the information contained in the UDA files on disk. We can then export the schema to data files. This will extract the schema from Umbraco and output it to the UDA files on disk. We can also clear the cached signatures. This is not something that should be necessary in normal use. However, it might solve reports of schema mismatches when transferring content between environments that has been aligned. And then lastly, we can also set the cached signatures. This can be used when signatures has been cleared and you want to ensure they have They are pre-generated before attempting a potentially long-running restore or transfer operations. Then we have the deploy, download deploy artifacts. This will download a zip file with all the deploy artifacts that is representing the Umbraco schema in the form of UDA files. These are very useful if you want to move to another Umbraco instance and you want to migrate the data with you. Awesome. Then we have the configuration details. This shows the environment's configuration as follows. The updates to the configuration should also be applied to the appsettings.json file. So we can see the configuration over here. We can see the setting options and we can see the current value and nodes over here, which tells a bit about the setting as well. You can click read more, which will direct you to our documentation for this specific setting as well. So we can see there's quite a few settings in here. I'm not going to go into much detail about these. However, I will add the link to the documentation down below. We then have schema comparison. The following table shows the schema information managed by Umbraco deploy. As we can see down here, we can first see the data types. We can see that there's 38 found and they are all up to date. We can see the name of the data type. We can see the file name here. We can see if it exists in Umbraco. We can see if the file exists and if it's up to date. We can then also view the details over here of the UDA file. We can also see for the dictionary items, for the document types, in this case there's 6 found, and they are as well up to date. We can again view the details of the UDA file down here. That's also for the languages, macros, media types, member groups, member types, relationship types, and finally the templates of your Umbraco project. Awesome. Great. That is all I have for you in this video. My name is Jonathan, and I'll see you in the next one. Jonathan, out.